Hello, everyone. Today, I'm thrilled to explore a recap of the 2023 Korean action comedy drama film Brave Citizen. This compelling story follows a former female boxing champion who, now working as a substitute high school teacher, decides to take justice into her own fists after witnessing intolerable violence. Now, let's dive into the recap. The movie kicks off in a high school that's been bagging the Best School Award for the last 2 years and where everyone seems to be living peacefully. A guy rolls up to school in his car named Hyung, the antagonist of the story, and there's another guy waiting to open his car door. But as soon as that door opens, it becomes clear that the school isn't as idyllic as it seems. Next up, we witness a group of students bullying another guy pretty viciously, going so far as to choke him until he passes out, then throwing him into a locker. The ringleader of this bullying crew is Hyung, and he's reveling in their sick game. Every time the bully guy loses, they slap him around. Hyung is totally enjoying the whole messed up situation. They even lock the beaten guy in a recording room, and the sounds of his suffering echo throughout the school. Shockingly, even though the teachers know what's going on, no one does anything about it. Cut to the next scene, where our leading lady is talking to another teacher. She's been assigned to this high school for a 3-month stint. While chatting, the school's dean shows up and drops a disrespectful comment about him. Both Si Min, our leading lady, and the other teacher get mad, but Si Min decides to bite her tongue. Later, in the bathroom, she's seething with anger over the dean's words, but she keeps quiet because she really wants a permanent job at the school. Then, two teachers spill the beans about the desk Si Min is supposed to use. It turns out that the previous teacher who sat there had committed suicide a few days ago. Si Min is understandably freaked out by this news. When she looks into it, she finds out that the poor teacher took his own life because he was relentlessly bullied by the students. Si Min gets a call, and as she exits, she puts on some headphones, pretending not to have overheard the teachers talking about him. Outside, she greets the teachers, and one of them starts telling her some important information about the school. The teacher pulls out her phone and shows Si Min a video featuring a brutal bullying incident carried out by a gang. Observing the video closely, Si Min identifies Hyung as the leader orchestrating the harassment. She informs Si Min about Hyung's violent past, revealing at home she channels her frustration by venting on her punching bag, disclosing her past as a boxer. In the subsequent scene, a police officer pays Si Min a visit. Si Min discloses that she got the job she was vying for, but the situation is so dire that she feels helpless to make a difference. It's revealed that Si Min's father, a former boxer who once received the Brave Citizen Award, had faced a downturn in life. Despite his past accolades, he struggled with adversity. During the conversation with her officer friend, Si Min reflects on the need to recognize when to stop and when to take action. As the discussion unfolds, Si Min shares that her father had supported someone, leading to insurmountable debt. Now she finds herself burdened with the same financial obligations. Having abandoned her boxing dreams due to these circumstances, Si Min's friend consoles her, emphasizing that no matter how negatively she views her father's actions, there's always room for redemption. But just like your father, you can't turn a blind eye to everything going wrong. When these words hit her, Si Min's gaze falls on a mask lying nearby, and she puts it on. It's evident that something is brewing in her mind. Si Min's fortunate streak takes a turn when one day she witnesses a boy in her class, the same one the bullying gang targeted earlier, facing severe harassment. The gang covers his mouth with plastic, and Si Min springs into action, delivering a beating. She notices that they've strategically covered the camera to avoid recording their actions on CCTV. Undeterred, Si Min resolves to enter and give them a lesson, but a boy named Han Soo blocks her path. He warns her that dire consequences await if she proceeds, as Hyung's family funds the school, granting her immunity from repercussions. Hyung threatens Lee, warning him that if he speaks out, his family will suffer. Hyung, the bullied boy, is on the verge of another attack when Si Min intervenes, causing both of them to tumble. Si Min feigns innocence, pretending it was an accident. Hyung confronts her, asking who she is, and a friend reveals that she's the replacement for the teacher who committed suicide because of Hyung. Enraged, Hyung takes out his anger on his friends, attacking them. Turning attention to Han Soo, it becomes apparent that he was receiving boxing training from Si Min's father, unbeknownst to him. His motive was to teach Hyung a lesson for fun, unaware that Si Min's father was the one imparting the training. Si Min calls Lee and asks if he informed the principal about the bullying. Lee responds that everyone knows, but no one came to his aid. Instead, he got answered to get transferred to another school, and they advised him to drop the issue. Lee shares that no one has the courage to punish Hyung. He even sought help from the police, but it was futile. Lee tells Si-min about the evidence he collected, which couldn't prove that Hyung's gang bully him. To make matters worse, Hyung's gang accused him of wrongdoing, leading to his return after informing the police. Unbeknownst to them, outsiders were videotaping the entire incident. The next day, Hyung's mom throws a party for the school staff to celebrate winning the best school award. Seeing the festivities, Si-min realizes her role as a mere servant, fearing that any action she takes might entangle her. Nevertheless, she decides to talk to Hyung, who rebuffs her and starts misbehaving. Hyung attempts to strike her, but Si-min intervenes. When Hyung dismisses her, she leaves without a word. Teachers receive a message about a complaint regarding severe bullying, and Si-min's senior teacher steps forward, stating that the punishment should be for the wrongdoer, not the complainant. Hyung's mom gets angry, slaps the lawyer, and accuses him of similar actions in the past. The dean gets involved, and Hyung's mother demands the complainer be found for punishment. Si-min steps forward, admitting to filing the complaint. Hyung's mother angrily demands Si-min's dismissal but is interrupted by Si-min, who pleads for forgiveness. But Hyung asks the dean not to fire Si-min. In the next scene, Hyung confronts Si-min in a store with his gang, bullying her. Hyung threatens to get her fired, but when Si-min ignores him, he grabs and holds her, demanding she become his girlfriend. Si-min remains silent, prompting Hyung to warn her to obey him or be useless. Despite the threats, Si-min walks away. As she accidentally bumps into a man, he turns out to be mentally unstable and begins misbehaving with her. Si-min becomes furious as the mentally unstable man continues to hit her. In self-defense, she delivers a strong kick, rendering him unconscious. Silently observing, Si-min later watches Hyung's team play basketball, and a collision leads to a fight between Hyung and another boy's team. Si-min puts on her cat mask for protection, she intervenes and starts kicking Hyung, causing him to fall. A brawl ensues and the police arrive, prompting everyone to disperse. After the police leave, Si-min removes her mask, revealing her happiness. He beats up Hyung and enjoys watching him face the consequences. Han-su, who watches the fight, realizes that the person behind the mask is Si-min and becomes very happy. Meanwhile, in school, the news of Hyung being beaten by a masked man spread. Students laughed at Hyung, and someone drew a funny and playful sticker of a cat on Hyung's desk to mock him, which angered him a lot. Han-su learns about Si-min's identity as his teacher daughter. Hyung started bullying Lee along with a group of friends, demanding that he undress and bring food for him. It's rumored that Lee goes to Han-su's restaurant to get food, but Han-su can't tolerate it. He immediately goes to Si-min and said that she is the one who beat Hyung. He says he knows because he is the one who called the police that day. And the story about the cat mask spreads throughout the school, exposing Hyung's lie to everyone. He is the one who did it at Han-su's request. She wears the mask and confronts Hyung. Hyung, upon seeing her, violently attacks her, and despite her boxing skills, Si-min is unable to defend herself. Si-min notices Lee approaching with a knife, realizing that Lee is about to attack Hyung. To prevent Lee from ruining his life by committing a crime, Si-min intervenes and gets stabbed. Meanwhile, Lee is brought to the restaurant. In the next scene, Si-min wakes up in the hospital and chooses not to inform the police to protect Lee from trouble. Hyung is worried and reflective. While wondering about the person behind the cat mask, another masked man appears, revealed to be Si-min's father. He had gone to beat Hyung but returned after being beaten. Si-min reflects on intentionally losing a boxing championship final to save her father's life and protect the gym. Her father disowned her, believing his daughter had died in the ring. At school, everyone is on edge, searching for the person with a cat mask due to a wound mark on their hand. Hyung recognizes Si-min by her cat-like move and confronts her, realizing she attacked herself to save Lee. Hyung bullies Si-min, challenging her to a boxing match. "If you don't box with me, I will make the video of Lee with a knife go viral," threatens Si-min, instigating Si-min adds teasing remarks, upsetting the senior teacher who overhears everything. Si-min learns about Lee transferring to another school and rushes to stop him from attempting suicide. She embraces him, promising to face Hyung together. The annual day festival features a boxing match between Hyung and Si-min. People roam around wearing cat masks to support the one wearing the cat mask. Si-min knows Han-su has spread the story to gain attention. Everyone wonders if the cat mask man will appear or not. The senior teacher says confidently that the brave citizen will reveal herself. A girl in a cat mask takes Si-min into the ring, and when Si-min lifts her mask, it's revealed to be Si-min herself. In a flashback, Si-min has always stood against evil, advocating for courage to bring change. Si-min enters the ring with her cat mask, surprising Lee and everyone. The fight begins, and Si-min realizes her father is watching. Hyung hits Si Min repeatedly, and as her hair comes loose, the truth about her gender is exposed. Si Min retaliates, vowing to make Hyung apologize to Lee. Dean intervenes, warning that Si Min's job won't be permanent if the fight continues. Si Min ignores the warning, and Hyung attacks her. Si Min counters, causing Hyung to hit Dean, who falls. Si Min applies a scissor kick to Hyung, demanding an apology to Lee. Hyung, tearful but defiant, refuses. Lee, however, states that he doesn't need an apology, Hyung has already lost. Hyung attacks Si Min, but she renders him unconscious with a powerful kick. Si Min assists Lee in filing a police complaint against Hyung, and later a girl files another complaint against Hyung, presenting a video as proof. The video exposes Hyung's truth, revealing that the teacher's suicide was caused by Hyung's actions. Si Min resigns from the school and joins her father's gym, and Hyung reaches his end. In the aftermath, Si Min reads about a school that had received the Best School Award. She discovers that a girl had recently committed suicide at that school. At school, Si Min notices a girl arriving in a car, glaring at her with evident anger. It appears this girl might be connected to the recent suicide. The girl exits the car and bullies her driver, prompting Si Min to recognize her mission to fight against such injustice. Si Min encounters her senior during the interview instead of the dean, expressing her desire to love and teach the children at the new school. In a symbolic gesture, Si Min carries cat mask in her bag, fully prepared for her new mission. The movie concludes with Si Min's smiling face, indicating her readiness for the challenges ahead. If you enjoyed this content, consider subscribing for more videos, turn on notifications, and leave a like to support the channel. Thank you for watching.